have been painful.
Yeah, it could have been painful.
Well, it kind of was.
Yeah, what happened to your forehead?
Well, I did my base toss routine, and my eye-hand coordination was a little out of sync.
So you got to really brush up on your choreography.
Yeah, that's right. I got to practice more, you know? I mean, and I got beaned on the noggin.
I didn't realize that happened to you, or I wouldn't have prodded you in the butt like that.
When did you prod me in the butt?
When you fell over backwards after we were done playing the song and I was prodding you in the butt. And I was going to jump on you and, like, attack you, but I realized that you were in pain at that time.
I just wanted to get off stage, man.
Oh, God,
I could tell that.
I was kind of embarrassed.
You're watching Bohemia After Dark, and this is our new video. Well, that's old now. Lithium.
That's old news.
It's old news.
Okay, how about we still play the old one off the
Cell Phone
Room?
The In Bloom one?
Huh?
The In Bloom one?
The blue one?
In Bloom?
Yeah.
That song?
Oh, yeah.
Let's say hi to Chad.
Okay.
Hi, Chad.
Hi, Chad. Playing drums on In Bloom in 1990 in New York City, in front of the New York Stock Exchange.
They were a tough crowd.
They were a tough crowd.
So what's the toughest crowd you guys ever played?
New York. They're pretty jaded there. Playing in front of 20 New York scum rockers.
You've seen it all. The trend of fascism is just rising and rising. You know, I watch the news and I see skinheads firebombing refugee centers in Germany. And to have it materialize so close to home is outrageous. And you got to fight back, you know. If you don't care, you're worse than the conservative fanatics that are implementing this on everybody. And you got to choose sides.
What do you say to people like out in the town and out in like the little outskirt part of Oregon that may not be as politically aware of what's going on as the people in Portland?
It was so surprising that it started in Springfield. I mean, just my first reaction was that, you know, Oregon's such a liberal state. I couldn't believe it. I mean, isn't Springfield really close to, like, Eugene? It's amazing. It's perfect proof that it can happen anywhere, and it will keep spreading. It'll start in small, obscure towns like that, you know?
Homosexuality is a natural thing, and to meddle with nature is going to cause a lot of friction. Like in society, you just can't repress something like that. You can't repress a person's feelings.
Is there any movement in something like Oregon's trying to do?
Well, I don't know if people in Washington really know what's going on down here. You know, it's a whole other state. I know it's a neighbor state, but we have our hands full up there with.
He's ahead of the East.
On there and just like watch ourselves.
They can get your social security
it's
number
really
anyway.
Nice. That's nothing. It's a big deal.
People, they're going to check you guys out.
Oh, they already have. It's been 3 years. They've been really listening to them. You know, and I'm sure that they already have. Or just whatever. They're not going to really want anything. But I'd rather not be worried about that and try to help. That's what everybody's afraid of on TV. That's why nobody, like, the TV is a bit far to right, far to left.
Oh, totally.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. The bottom line at MTV is a dollar bill. I mean,
yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah.
Like, everybody's doing well-being, you know.
We had a bad experience with MTV this last weekend. It's like we got kicked off the awards show.
Why?
Because we didn't want to play Smells Like Teen Spirit. I mean, we're bored of that song, and that song was just running into the ground. And we were told if we didn't play Smells Like Teen Spirit, we'd be kicked off the awards show. So we were, and then After
it was just
kind
of, it was this battle right up to the last second of, you know, before we were supposed to play. Well, actually, a few hours before we were supposed to play that night.
And not only were we going to be kicked off the award show, there was going to be repercussions way down the line.
Right, it was really incestuously political problem. I mean, it was going to jeopardize a lot of people that we work with, jobs and stuff. It was like,
yeah. And when it boiled down to
it was the first time we ever felt like real whores,
yeah,
you know.
Scary.
It was,
that's why we don't see, we've been crushed by Budweiser. I don't ever want to be controlled by something like that.
No.
MTV goes against like their rules that they've set with the record label and been kind of like fast. So like when everything is crazy, you have to like, go by so them being the most important, you know,
right.
And us kind of being like not really important, you know.
Yeah, MTV is definitely the tail shaking the dog. I mean, they have so much influence in the record company. It's really scary. I mean, bands aren't. And you asked me what I'd like to change in the music industry if I could, is I'd like to eliminate the chart system, and I'd like to base a band, merit a band on its music, than on how much product it's shipped.
Or
you know what I mean?
Or have it to CBC.
Exactly.
Like
exactly.
That.
Exactly.
Also, at MTV, there are a handful of really sincere, good-hearted people who really do like music, and they're just constantly fighting. They're always putting their job on the line. Like, every day, almost, they have to, like, stand up and say, well, I'm going to quit unless you let this band play, or something like that. I mean, we've met a few really great people that work there.
Right.
And that's the way it is in the whole industry, you know. There's just a handful of people, but they're really making an impact. They're at least, they're progressing. They really are.
And some of that good stuff filters through, like, you know, Choose or Lose, or you know. I saw an ad for, this is MTV Family Values, and they were, like, selling a family. And that was, like, that was definitely anti-right-wing Republican. Stop, beep.
What do you think of Portland? If you're from Portland, bands around here, do you listen to any of that stuff?
Oh,
like,
sure.
What local bands do you like to listen to?
Well, I've always been a real big fan of Poison and Idea.
Hitting Bird
is good. And the Wipers are like
God
to us. I mean, any band influenced us, the Wipers influenced us more than anything.
Portland seems a lot more organic and pure than what's happened to Seattle. Seattle's been gang raped.
Yeah.
And, sometimes willingly. So. Where's that? The X-ray, really?
That would be so rad. It's just a very small club. It's really kind of close.
Maybe we will.
It's very cool. You can get about 120 people in there if you're lucky. And it's the best bed in town as far as no hassle, fun, good time.
So it's
all ages?
It's an all ages. Wow, that's great.
Like, on Tuesday nights, they have primal screens on Sunday.
The Washington State Music Industry Coalition is looking into changing the regressive alcohol laws in Washington State regarding minors. I mean, all ages shows are uncommon, and it's a real shame. I mean,
I took him to be up there and play for Robin Taylor. That was a really cool experience. All ages club, OK Hotel.
Yeah. OK Hotel.
Robin's
right.
Still doing that?
No,
they're not. The city council.
It's acoustic now. They had a dance ordinance there for a long time too.
Yeah,
they
came in with NBC. I had to talk to them. They had like 450 people there when we went up there.
They had the stage diving. It's essentially the same kind of thing that's going on here.
Right.
The city fathers are a little bit less benevolent.
You hit the nail right on the head. I mean, it's insurance. A lot of stage diving goes on, and some kid gets hurt, the parent sues the venue, sues the band.
You thought that was gone for?
asking all these housewives their opinions.
Right. What it is that there's just a glut of lawyers. There's more lawyers right now in the United States than there's ever been. And, you know, they just want to go out there, and the kid will be laying on the hospital bed. He'll probably be seen by 5 lawyers.
Can you sign with your teeth?
Yeah, sign with your teeth right here, right. Right. There was a Simpsons about that. Remember when Bart got hurt on the skateboard?
Yeah.
That's not what it was all about. Now, there's subversion in the mainstream. Funny thing about the Simpsons is a lot of people just like, hey, Bart, man, you're cool, and they don't see the subversion in it.
Oh, yeah.
They forget the radioactive thing that
Homer
throws and, you know.
Right, yeah.
We're almost out of battery pack and
Hi, we're Nirvana, and
you're watching us on Bohemia After Dark.
Picture on the news about 3 weeks ago. It was a Republican Party headquarters in Pasadena, and it was firebombed. It was a beautiful picture. It was a picture of the Republican Party headquarters in Pasadena. There's a window, and there's smoke and fire coming out of it. It's really pretty. It should be like a Christmas song. Did you know that I'm gay? To a hermaphrodite. But if someone tried to take away my gay rights, I would have been really mad because I really like to butt fuck. It's fun.
Watch you. fascism going on. Thanks a lot to Calamity Jane, if you were here earlier this year, we were rocking. Thanks to Poison Idea. They're from Portland, so check them out, your hometown, right? Thanks a lot to Helmet. And thanks a lot to Joe Biafra. In the 1990s, check out his recording. I blow minds for a living. I don't, it blow my mind.
Stopped.
he turned around, pointed his finger at my wife.
His bodyguard.
Yeah, well, he had like 20 bodyguards with him, and he's doing the Madonna documentary. He's got his little film camera with him.
And you had a 3-week-old baby in your arms.
And I had a little helpless child in my arms. And so he said to my wife, "You better shut up, bitch. Don't pitch me any shit tonight." Because tonight was obviously the highlight of his career. See, the last night.
He said, faggots. He said so.
And then I said, and then he said, and then he looked at me and he said, "You better keep your wife shut, or I'm gonna take you to the pavement." I was shaking and I went, "What? What? You're gonna, what are you gonna do? You're gonna beat me up?" And he said, "You better keep your wife's mouth shut. You embarrass everybody. You embarrass your wife, you embarrass your old man, you embarrass me." And then I was shaking and I said, I told my wife to shut up, bitch.
True story, you heard it here first.
So,
and then I ran into Duff McKagan. That guy wanted to fight me. And he had 3 bodyguards who were like pushing me around. But it's tough. But see, that's the establishment rock and roll, see.
What?
They want you to buy their package rebellion of sitting on a Harley Davidson while you play piano with a 41-piece orchestra, just like Emerson, Lake, and Palmer did in 1970. Say it, brother.
Hey, man. I'm not sticking up for Axel or anything.
But?
I'm not going to stick up for Kurt, man.
Well, you got to take sides. Either you're yes on 9 or you're no on 9, man. You got to take sides.
No on 9, but I'm talking about Axel here. Just hang on a second.
You're talking about an asshole?
I think you guys should let music be music, man. Let everybody express what they want, man.
Yeah.
Be it a hard rock, be it Nirvana,
right
be
on,
it
man.
Anyone, man. Just let them rock the way they want to rock,
yeah,
okay?
Yeah, right on, man. But
all right?
That's a corporate establishment. Which
but you can't let a rock star who obviously likes to beat women and likes to control women and who likes to tell women to shut up.
And who hates niggers and
bitches. Is a racist and a homophobe. He doesn't have the right to speak his mind. Well, he does have the right to speak his mind,
no,
but so do we, and he should
I'm
be
I'm not sticking up for him, man. That's my girlfriend, Jennifer, okay? She just got a little excited.
Shut up.
We're having a discussion here. This is forum. Pure Americana here.
It's cool.
It's a, we're having a forum.
It's true. We should all just love one another.
You've only got like 5 seconds left anyways. Oh, really? You're about to cut off, huh?
Chris?
Yeah.
I love you.
John, report over Calamity Jane.